All right, welcome back. A skateboarding prodigy quickly rising to fame, lost it all though to addiction. Brandon Novak, hooked on heroin and other drugs for more than 2 decades. Now happy to tell you he is clean and sober, and he's joining us now in the studio to spread the message that it is never too late to go out and get some help. Brandon, so thank you so much for being here. Tell me about your story. First, how did you get hooked on heroin and how did you get clean?
Wow, you know, it's hard to encapsulate.
I know, it's a lot to ask for.
But, you know, I was very successful at a young age. So people believed in me because I was so successful. So by the time drugs and alcohol got a hold on me, I was already too far gone to be reeled back in. Because there wasn't a lot of accountability in my life. It wasn't like I was a guy that had to be in when the street lights went on. And I was traveling the world with pro skaters at the age of 14.
You're also on a lot of famous shows that, yeah, that we know very well.
Yeah, yeah.
And so that you're saying that did not help because you had a lot of people enabling you in, yeah, your life and not putting you in your place to stop.
Yeah, and then at the point in time when I was in those movies, Jack A, yeah, you know, I would do appearances at nightclubs, and, yeah, they would say, what do you want in your green room? And I'd say some heroin, some cocaine, some Xanax, and some wine, and they would get me those things, and then I would get a check for $10,000. You know, so it was almost like my job to get high for a period of time.
Of course, Tony Hawk recognized you.
Yeah.
You had Gatorade. You're one of the first with Gatorade to, yeah, to be a sponsor of them and be a pro skater. I mean, so you had at no point any way of stopping you. So how did you eventually stop?
You know, I had did things in life that people attributed to success. Mm-hmm. You know, I was a New York Times seller. Mm-hmm. I'd been in movies at Breakbox Office Records, mm-hmm, for a professional skateboarder, first to be endorsed by Gatorade. But at the end of my drug and alcohol run, mm-hmm, I was a 35-year-old man who had been in 13 inpatient treatment centers, mm-hmm, lost count of outpatients and detoxes. My mother bought me a plot. People had taken life insurance policies out on me. Mm-hmm. I had just got off life support for 7 days.
Unbelievable.
And I walked in homeless to my 13th inpatient treatment center. My worldly possessions consisted of 8 scarves, 2 jackets, 3 socks, and 1 stick of deodorant, with my mother going to God with one prayer, and that prayer consists of, God, please cure him, kill him, or kill me, because I can't take it anymore. And what I realized was my very best thinking had got me there. Mm-hmm. If I would just get out of my way, mm-hmm, because I always felt that I knew everything because I was successful at a young, right, mm-hmm, you know, young age. Mm-hmm.
You thought you had all the answers.
Yeah.
So if folks go get this book, Dream Seller, New York Times bestseller, what advice do you have in there for somebody right now that is dealing with addiction? How can they start? What could be the first step they could even take?
You know, that the disease of addiction is not a death sentence. And as long as you're breathing, it's never too late. Mm-hmm. And your history does not have to dictate your future. Mm-hmm. Do me a favor, reach out for help, because, mm-hmm, I can't do it alone. Mm-hmm. But together, me and another alcoholic, a recovering alcoholic, can do it.
And you actually started a scholarship because you want more people to be able to afford to go to rehab. Tell me about that.
Absolutely.
How does
that work? There's not enough resources out there. And I work with Banyan Treatment Center. We're located in Philadelphia, Chicago, Boston, and several facilities in Florida. And we realize that the resources are not available for everybody, and we offer out scholarships, so which is free treatment, detox, and a full length of stay. And if anyone's interested in it, they can go to BanyanTreatmentCenter.com and look up grassroots.
That's wonderful.
Scholarship.
You're also doing something that a lot of people do not do, very unusual. You actually want your personal cell phone number out there because you want people to be able to call you and get advice, and you could walk them through how to get some help. What is that why you do,
yeah,
that?
Yeah, well, I mean, because the reality is for 25 years I struggled, and every time I called someone for help, they answered. So how dare, mm-hmm, I finally get sober and stay sober and not pay that forward? It doesn't even make sense to me.
So we got your number right there,
yeah,
on the bottom of the screen, 610-546-2608. If you or a loved one are dealing with addiction right now and you feel like you need some help, you're the perfect person to talk to about it. You've come out the other side, but, yeah, I'm sure it's still a struggle every day, right?
Yeah. Well, I suffer from a disease called alcoholism, mm-hmm, not alcoholism. So, mm-hmm, I can't stay sober on yesterday's sobriety. Mm-hmm. I do a few simple things along the way each day to maintain my sobriety, mm-hmm, and I have a really nice life.
Well, Brandon, we're happy to have you here.
Thank you for having me.
All the success in the world. Good luck with the book and, of course, the scholarship as well.
Yeah, call me if you need help.
Very nice. Brandon, thank you so much. Aaron, we're going to toss it back to you.
Wow, what a story.